Praise God. My name is Rosemary Kwaka. I want to testify about God's goodness. I came to know about Ratsi in 2020 after struggling in religion for 5 years. Maybe just to hint on somehow what religion does to a person. This religion that I'm talking about is more of a cult, kinda. So first, it kills your sense of reasoning. Most often, you find yourself agreeing with everything your spiritual leader tells you, even if it's contrary to the word of God. Secondly, for different groups, there's a way of doing things, i.e. that is dressing, association, among others, of which anyone who does not conform to this is titled as a worldly person, according to the group. These are just but few things that I was so deep into. I had sat under teaching that mostly was centered on rapture, holiness, and sin. This was taught so much to a point that I used to have dreams and panic attacks whenever I heard loud sound or noise. Somehow I used to relate them to trumpet sound and I was left behind. The funny bit of it all, I struggled with sin so much and there was no spiritual growth whatsoever. The only growth I had was fear and more fear. Early 2020, I came across a post by Reverend Danu on supernatural childbirth. I was so marveled by her faith in God and I started following her post. Through it, God revived my quench and thirst for truth in him, and I landed in Ratsi, that is November last year. First day I came here, Pastor was teaching about a series of healing, and he had a word of knowledge about somebody who was having a back pain. Since 2020, around July, I had a sensational pain on my spinal cord, and it used to affect my left side. Sometimes it would just go numb, and I was so afraid of going to the hospital. That day, Pastor Benjamin was teaching on healing and he had word of knowledge about my condition. He prayed and that was it. I have been privileged to sit under the word of God and I have grown tremendously. I have learned every truth concerning my identity in Christ Jesus. I first got baptized in the Holy Spirit here with evidence of speaking in tongues. I, for the first time, learned how to hear the voice of God for myself. I experienced the love of God for the very first time in this sanctuary. This is where I first experienced the tangible presence of God. I'm grateful to God that he led me here, and I'm so grateful for the leadership of Pastor Benjamin and Reverend Nanu. I am free from religion.